What's yours is mine, and what's mine is mine. Maybe you've heard that phrase before. Maybe you've been in a relationship with someone where that was the mentality. That was the response that you had in talking about finances or time or people or places or things or whatever it might be. Oftentimes you find in toxic relationships, they don't have those boundaries to be able to differentiate between what is yours and what is theirs. In narcissism in particular, a lot of times I hear in talking to people, in going through one-on-ones, different like sessions where I'm talking to people, and they come out and they say that phrase that's been told to them multiple times. That the narcissist actually came out and said, it was actually that clear and came out and said, what's yours is mine and what's mine is mine. And it's amazing how that thought process becomes so prevalent in the narcissist's mind. For me, with narcissism and having that impact my life and impact my family, that's what I thought for the longest time. Like, I thought everything was owed to me. I thought everything was in my control. I thought everything was mine. And so as a result, I would control more, I would manipulate more, I would gaslight more to make sure that I got exactly what I wanted. That's oftentimes what a narcissist is doing. They're trying to make sure that they stay the center of someone's universe, that they're in the control of everything around them, and that they're the most important person. Oftentimes, the most important person is the one that's holding all the cards. So for a narcissist, controlling all the finances, controlling all the inputs into your life, like your friends, your family, controlling every single aspect of your life, where you are, who you're with, how much time you're spending there, how much money you're spending there, etc., etc. You see that a lot of times with narcissism, they become very, very possessive over the people that are in their lives. They'll get possessive to the point of being so controlling, so manipulative. It's very crazy as far as how much they will control. I remember in talking to someone on a one-on-one, like they were saying like how their narcissist was very controlling of them going to the store or going to Starbucks. And they'd go to Starbucks and then come back and they'd be like, you were late. Like, why were you this many minutes late? Like, who did you talk to? Like, what was happening? Like, what, are you cheating on me? Like, what's going on? Like, all this type of stuff starts perpetuating these arguments, these frustrations, and these narcissistic moments that they lash out at the other person for not fulfilling a certain criteria or not making sure that they understand, hey, you are mine. This is mine. See, narcissists oftentimes are very possessive over people and over things because a lot of times they're still viewing people as being things in their lives. And as a result, it's just a piece of property. It's a person that is doing a service for them. It's someone that is just fulfilling a role or a means to an end because a lot of that type of interaction is very transactional. I do something for you, I expect something in return. When you get involved more and more with a toxic person, I do something small for you, I expect something giant in return. And that's the mentality and the thought process that keeps going over and over and over. So they'll come out with these phrases, they'll come out saying, yours is mine, what mine is mine, they'll start controlling every single aspect of your life. Another person that I talked to, they didn't have access to their house. The house is one of those automated, fully automated, electronic access codes, all things like that. They didn't actually have keys or physical access to the house, but they had to text the other person to be able to be let in and let out of the house. Like, we're talking like a lot of this stuff getting like sociopathic, psychopathic with how much control people are trying to exude over other people, whether that's just to keep supply, whether that's to manipulate, whether that's to be able to hold that over them, to be able to enjoy that concept of just manipulating and controlling someone. Not sure. Every aspect is different. Every aspect, there's a different way, a different aspect that it comes out. But with this type of thing, toxic people, narcissists are very, very controlling. So you might be thinking like, yeah, they're controlling, but they don't seem to match up. Well, they're also very hypocritical on the other side. So they're controlling about what you do with finances, and then they'll go out and they'll spend all your money. They're controlling what you'll do with who you're with, and then they'll ghost and disappear for hours, weeks on end. It's very much of a giant disconnect of what they expect other people to do versus what they're willing to do or willing to contribute in the relationship. Because again, as we look at narcissism, it's all about themselves. It's all about them being number one. It's all about the focus being 100% only on them and not caring about anyone else. As a result, when you have someone, or when you have like a narcissist that's at the pinnacle and everybody else, everything else, every person is underneath them, then everything just cascades down. How they feel, how they think, how they act, how they talk, everything below that doesn't really matter. Because the narcissist is only thinking about themselves. They're only thinking about what they get. They're only thinking about what they do. They're only thinking about how they get it. And they're going to try to manipulate, gaslight, and do whatever they can to get to that end result that they get what they want. Please be careful if you're with a narcissist or in a narcissistic relationship, because oftentimes it can ruin people, not just mentally, not just emotionally, not just physically, but financially too. There's stories and stories of different people that I've talked to, that other people on here have talked to, that have talked about, I didn't want to give it to him, but I gave him my last paycheck because he said that he was going to do this, this, and this, and then he disappeared with it. Or he lost all his money, like gambling, and said that he was going to be different this time, told me a plan, took the money, lost it all again. Oftentimes you'll see narcissists that are very controlling with money and also very manipulative to be able to get money. To be able to get money from another person. Not necessarily as much like hardworking or get money that way, but how can they swindle someone out of their money? How can they be able to take someone's money and be able to use it for their own gain, for their own profit, or be able to get you in debt? To be careful, like signing on with something, like signing on for a car, signing on for a house loan, anything like that, because oftentimes you're left holding the bag while the narcissist disappears. This is why a lot of times when they leave a relationship and they leave a family, so wife, husband, and there's kids involved, a lot of times they don't even come back to pay any type of child support. So people be trying for months and for years to get something out of the narcissist of like, hey, you contributed by producing these people, so you need to contribute by helping financially as well. And you don't see that. Because they don't view that anymore as being a part of what they're responsible for, what they care about. They've moved on and then just keep moving on to the next person. Who else can I control? Who else can I manipulate? Anyways, that's a little bit about narcissism for today. If you like what you see here, please follow me. Please give comments. I'm trying to get better at my content, I'm trying to get better at just building awareness about narcissism and showing people how I'm on the road of healing, growth, and change. And that's why I'm on here. If you want to talk sometime, reach out to me, rawmotivations.com, one-on-ones. That's where I talk with people like one-on-one over a Zoom call, things like that. I talk to two different types of people. I talk to narcissists, and I also talk to people that are involved in a narcissist relationship who've been abused in that type of mentality. And we talk through trauma bonds. We talked through, like, did the narcissist actually care about you? We talk through multiple different things to try to be able to get you to a place of healing and growth that we you can continue to change and be the best person possible. If you follow me on podcasts, either Apple Podcasts or Spotify, thank you so much. Rate me just so we can get this message out to more people out there. Thank you.